Unlike science, which sees it as a challenge, religion thrives on unsolved mystery. For early humanity, what was mysterious and unexplained was so vast that only an equally vast higher being, an alpha male in the sky, could fill that gap.
How would our ancestors have responded to the sunrise? There must be a fiery charioteer, a sun god to accept our sacrifices, a supreme being who, on the first day of creation, announced, "Let there be light."
But scientific investigation has rolled back that mystery. Today we know the sun is a giant nuclear reactor, one of billions of stars pumping out electromagnetic radiation, heat and light. How do scientists know the things that they know about the world and the universe? How do we know, for instance, that the Earth is 4.5 billion years old, and that it orbits the sun that nourishes it?
How do we know that these dinosaurs are hundreds of millions of years old? The answer is evidence. Tons and tons of mutually supporting evidence.
Science is about testing, comparing and corroborating this mass of evidence, and using it to update old theories of how things work.
I do remember one formative influence in my undergraduate life. There was an elderly professor in my department who had been passionately keen on a particular theory for, a number of years. And one day an American visiting researcher came, and he completely and utterly disproved our old man's hypothesis. The old man strode to the front, shook his hand and said, "My dear fellow, I wish to thank you. I have been wrong these 15 years. And we all clapped our hands raw. That was the scientific ideal of somebody who had a lot invested, a lifetime almost invested in the theory. And he was rejoicing that he had been shown wrong and that scientific truth had been advanced.